Our labs are back in and everything looks normal. How are you feeling?
Fine, I guess. What happened to me?
Well, you had an asthma attack, but you're okay now. Have you been prescribed anything for your asthma in the past?
I have this circular one, and I also have this pushy one, but I don't really use them because I don't need it.
You really should be using your medications. They might have prevented this attack. I want to refer you to our respiratory pharmacist, Dr. Shah. She's going to give you some information so that hopefully this doesn't happen again in the future, okay?
Okay.
She'll be in a couple of minutes.
Okay, thank you.
Hello, I'm Dr. Shah. I'll be your respiratory pharmacist
today.
I understand that you were prescribed an inhaler for your asthma.
Yeah.
Your friend brought it in while you were sleeping. Can you please tell me what your doctor told you this was for?
He said that it would help me breathe better, but I mean, my breathing isn't too bad, so I don't really take it.
So from what I understand, you're only taking this medication when you have difficulty breathing. How exactly did the doctor tell you to take this medication?
I think he said, once in the morning and then, once in the evening as well, every day, but I mean, I don't really need it, so I don't take it.
Well, you should be taking this medication every day. This discus is supposed to prevent your asthma attacks and not treat them. So if you take it every day, your breathing will get better. And also...
Okay, wait. So you're saying that if I take this every day, I'm going to breathe better and that it'll only work if I take it every day?
Correct.
Okay.
Also, if you miss a dose, you can take it as soon as you remember it. And you should also store your discus in a cool, dry place to keep it working properly. You should be keeping up with your refills. You should never be without your discus.
Okay.
All right?
Yeah.
Okay, so since you haven't been taking this medication regularly, I was wondering if you were aware of the side effects of this medication.
Well, I know that my voice gets really hoarse, and that's one of the reasons why I don't like to take it.
Okay, I understand. As you know, most medications have their side effects, but we shouldn't let these side effects stop us from taking them.
Yeah.
Okay? In this case, with the discus, you might experience some hoarseness, like you said, or maybe even a throat infection. But you can do things to relieve yourself from these side effects. For example, with throat infection, you could prevent yourself from getting one by just rinsing your mouth out with water after every inhalation. Okay?
Yeah.
And in your case, you said you had hoarseness.
Yeah.
In your throat voice.
Yeah.
So you should take candy lozenges. This might help you relieve this side effect. Okay?
Yeah, that sounds good. I'll try some candy lozenges.
Great. Okay, before I let you go, could you please show me how you've been using your discus?
Well, like I said, I haven't been really taking it, so could you show me again?
Of course.
Put the discus in your hand. Hold the discus in one hand and put the thumb of the other hand on the thumb grip. Push the thumb away until the mouthpiece appears and snaps into position. Inspect the device for foreign material. Hold the discus in a level, horizontal position with the mouthpiece towards me. Push the lever away until it clicks. Every time the lever is pushed back, a dose is ready to be inhaled. Exhale completely. Put the mouthpiece to lips, inhale deeply and quickly through the discus. remove the discus from mouth, hold breath for at least 10 seconds, close the discus by sliding thumb grip back over the mouthpiece.